My name is Assistant Organizer for the invitation. And it's really my pleasure to give a lecture here. So let me first start this lecture by explaining what I'm going to do in these three lecture series. In particular, today and tomorrow's lecture, I will talk about the equivalence of deformation theories for rank one case. And in tomorrow's lecture, I will talk about this equivalence for. So let me first explain what the deformation theory is. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to explain the equivalence of three deformation theories, which are called the D-groupoid and drum-groupoid and dolgo-groupoid, which I will define shortly later. And what I'm going to do today is actually I'm going to explain the equivalence for the tibia case, which is the simplest case for this equivalence, which is the rank one case. Tomorrow, I will explain the equivalence for higher rank case. Now, moreover, today I will also give examples concerning these three deformation space. And after we knowing the equivalence of three deformation space, then the geometry of one deformation space will characterize or will give the other information on the other deformation space. And in this very trivial toy model, we can see this information very trivially, but in tomorrow's lecture, this very trivial case will be generalized to somewhat deeper and complicated fact about the moduli space of rank 2 Higgs bundle, or another way to say that is characterized for PSL to C. Now, let me first give elementary deformation. Now let me address the problem which I'm going to prove today. First, it is a very well known fact that representation is corresponding to flat connections. This correspondence is actually very is proved by André Weil around 1930. So this fact is very classical. Actually, what I'm going to do today is give some idea of this proof, as well as I will introduce a new object which exactly corresponds to this flat connection. So this object is actually coming from gauge theory. So it is really a modern object, and in order to define this, we need modern gauge theory. Actually, rank 1 case, we don't need that kind of thing, but in the rank 2 case, we actually need this kind of the modern Yang-Mills theory. Now, let me give some elementary definition for which I'm going to explain. So, but deformation theory consists of category C with group G action. Here, from this definition, the deformation theory, the multiplication in this category C is in fact always an isomorphism. So, this category is a little different from the usual category. And another definition to make is an equivalence of two deformation theories requires three conditions. First condition is surjection of moduli space of isomorphism classes, which means we have a G group action, so we can make equivalence class of G orbit. That's the moduli, that's the isomorphism class. So see what I mean by that. And another requirement is there is a functor between two categories, which is full and faithful. The full means subjective on this this direction, and faithful means injective for this direction. So if we have a full and faithful functor, then we have the bijective correspondence between space of two morphisms. I will define. This is just a general definition for deformation theory. So first deformation theory which I'm going to define is what is called Bentigropoid. So object in Bentigropoid is nothing but representation from pi 1 to g. Throughout this lecture, I will restrict myself to the pi 1 to be always a fundamental group of compact Riemann surface of genus g, and this group g is depending on situation, it would be real E group or complex E group. Now, what I wanted to say is this space of representation is an algebraic variety by following reason. Because pi 1 is fundamental group of compact Riemann surface, so we have the usual relation of generator of that fundamental group, and that relation, so we have only one relation, this one, without this row. So after defining this map to the Cartesian product of 2G Cartesian product of this E group G. So let me say this again. So G is let's say G is a matrix group. So G is an algebraic group. So we can define this map and with this one relationship. Then it is hard to say that this is a polynomial relation. And it will define a algebraic variety in this space. And this is the vector. I'm assuming this is an algebraic group. So this is an algebraic variety. But the problem is, so after making this space of homomorphism as an algebraic variety, let's take quotient space. So the action of G. Action of G on this space of homomorphism is given by the conjugation action, the usual one. But the problem is if we take the usual quotient of that group action, then it is well known that that space tended to be non-Hausdorff space. So throughout this lecture, when I take the quotient, it means it's a GIT quotient. I don't want to explain exactly what is GIT quotient, but let me give a brief idea of that quotient space. So as I told before, this space, the usual just quotient space is not half of the space. So let's take the subspace, or let's take an element which gives after quotienting the half of the space. set some kind of maximal, so let's take the maximal count of space inside of this somewhat not well defined space. Then that's usually what I will call GIT quotient. Now, let's study the local structure of this space of homomorphism. So in order to study the space of the local structure of that the character variety, so first let me introduce some notation. So add row representation is a composition of two representations, which is from pi to g is given by representation rho, and g to this real algebra of g is given by adjoint representation. Adjoint representation is in fact given by just the usual one. Now the add rho representation is in fact defined, is a composition of two representations. Now, I will define the group homology. But, in fact, it's not hard to give the full general definition of group homology. But, today I don't, in fact, need the higher group homology. In fact, I don't need the higher top, the higher group homology. Definition of higher group homology. So let me just first group definition of first and zeroth group homology, which I need only today. Zeroth group homology is nothing but the fixed point of this L2 representation. This is my definition. And the first group homology is in fact given by the space of what this is usually called the closed homomorphism, rather by the homomorphism induced by the element of this G. And usually I will denote this space as G1. And I will denote this space as V1 space. So this in the definition of group homology, this is indeed the closed cycle. And this is indeed the co-boundary cycle. Even though I did not give the definition, sure. So this is the first group homology, definition of first group homology. Now, this is a well-known theorem that the tangent space at rho is the element in here, of this homomorphism variety, is in fact the space of this G1, the closed cycle, which is the space of closed homomorphism, and the tangent space of this quotient space, this is a GIT quotient space at rho is nothing but the first group homology. So let me give the idea of this proof of this one. The idea is somewhat simple. So just represent this tangent vector as a tangent floor like this way. And because rho t is homomorphism, so we have this homomorphism condition. And just to differentiate both sides. In this side, just differentiate. And so here, mu is some map from pi 1 to real algebra of G associated with this tangent vector. Now, let's differentiate this side and this side. And using same rule, you can differentiate this side. Then just comparing both sides, then you will get this identity. And if you consider, this is the first variation of the tangent vector. If you consider the tangent floor, if you consider the second variation, which means you can have a t squared term here, and something, and OT3, the t third. Then, again using exactly this homomorphism condition and the differentiate both sides, you can have an obstruction class, which means actual tangent space is in fact defined by this condition. This is a polynomial condition. In fact, this is even Chayefsky tangent space. So some singular point, the space is quite bigger than actual dimension. But that is in fact characterized by this tangent cone. So this is the defined indication of tangent cone here. Now, let me define the second group point which I'm going to study today. Let me first give us some elementary definition. The connection on smooth complex vector bundle of a rank R over compact Riemann surface is the differential operator that is defined as a Leibniz rule. Here, what is important is, in throughout this lecture, I will consider complex vector bundle. So rank means complex rank, but that does not mean this holomorphic vector bundle. So what I'm saying is just a smooth complex vector bundle of rank R. And so here, so any the function should be C infinity C valued function. Now after fixing a trivialization of this complex vector bundle, we can decompose this connection D eta to D0 plus eta. Here, D0 is what is called a flat connection associated with that trivialization. So what I'm saying is trivialization is flat with respect to this D0, which is the parallel with respect to D0. So once you fix a trivialization, then you can have this decomposition, and this eta is in fact the element of the endomorphism valued one form. Now, let me give another definition, the curvature. The curvature associated with the connection is endomorphism E valued two form on this compact Riemann surface. And by definition, this one gives this. The curvature is given by composition of the connection twice, and in terms of this trivialization, you will see that this curvature is invented by this way. Now, flat connection means this curvature. When curvature is zero, then we say that this is flat connection. Now, let me give another definition. The symplectic form on the even dimensional smooth manifold is a closed non-degenerate skew symmetric form. Now, let's consider the space of all the connections on this smooth complex vector bundle. Now, let's note that this space is an infinite dimensional space. Hence, what I'm going to give is I would like to define a symplectic form on this infinite dimensional space which generalizes this concept. Now, let's assume our group is reductive, then you always have this symmetric non-degenerate bilinear pairing on the algebra. And the disease, so when disease GI, it is just trace form. And let me define the symptomatic form as in this way. So let's check this to satisfy the requirement of being symptomatic form here. This is non-degenerate because our bees are by assumed to be non-degenerate. And we have a concurrent duality. So using concurrent duality and this non-degeneracy of concurrent duality and non-degeneracy of this one, it's not hard to say that this is non-degenerate. And this is a skewed symmetric form because this is a symmetric form and this reciprocal of this skewed symmetry. And the whole expression is skewed symmetry. Now, it is closed form. The closed form means this symmetric form is not constant. So every point is defined by the same way. So it's independent of this any point. So which means it is closed. Now, it is very remarkable observation by Attia and Bhatt that the curvature map from space of connection to this space is a momentum map. I will define what is a momentum, what the momentum map is in symmetric geometry. So, a momentum map is a smooth map from the finite dimensional simplifying manifold, this is simplifying manifold to dual algebra of we assume there is a simple the group action on M2N by simple morphism. The fiction is that group action preserves the simplifying form and that dual algebra of dual algebra is in fact that the dual algebra of the symplectic group. In a smooth method step, the exterior differential of this pairing, this is in fact dual pairing from this um is text value in dual algebra and x is element in this g, the algebra here. Is in fact given by this is a symplectic form. And x sharp is the special vector field on M2N. With x. So this is more in the legal theory, less in the red vector field. And another requirement is this momentum map is equivalent with respect to that group action. Which means that here always the G action on dual algebra I think is always given by coefficient action on that. Now, of course the momentum map might not exist in general case. So even though you have a symplectic manifold, you cannot find this kind of map. But
what is the
impact? This tangent. This is the function. This is the duality pair. This value in here and x is here. This is the function on M2. It's just it's tangent, but your hands, this is one form. Yeah, that's one form. That's your answer. So, in general, you cannot find that any momentum map in symplectic manifold. But if there exists a momentum map, if there momentum map exists, then we say that the action of G on M2N is Hamiltonian. So Attia Bhatt theorem says the gauge group action on space of connection is in fact Hamiltonian action. Let me prove that theorem first. and indicated major. So indicated major case is where you, if we require the map satisfied these two conditions, probably we can say it's momentum.
That's it.
So it's more of a generalization of the now, it is well known fact that the gauge group action on the curve itself is given by this conjugation action. In fact, if you change the gauge, then it's well known that the space connection is not tensor, which means you cannot, in fact, by changing gauge, you cannot transform one connection to another. You have some kind of extra. So, if you make the gauge reaction on space on connection, then you will get some kind of this kind of count. Probably. So, if you think of this gauge, then some this unpleasant extra term will be added there. But in terms of this curvature, which is the composition of connection twice, in fact, it's very well known fact that you can, the action becomes this. That means it's a coexistent action. And so, the curvature map, in fact, satisfies the first condition of this one, and second condition of this one. And moreover, in order to prove the second condition, the main idea to prove the second condition is characterization of the associated vector field as a derivation of this. Derivation of this DL spread element. So this is vector field on this infinite dimensional space. The eta is pointing that the Cauchy A space, the space of connection. So that tangent vector is in fact given by this that point as a centripetal derivation of this DL spread. And the vector field is in fact given by this. That's the main observation of at the alpha. So in fact, the proof of this one is not that hard. So in fact, the gauge group action is in fact given by this expression T delta, and so let's say to delta. If you differentiate this expression, so what you just gain is more or less this expression. Using this observation, it is really not hard to inspect prove this condition. And so that can be only that thing. And in the finite dimensional case, if you have a momentum map, then you can take what is called Marsden-Weinstein singularity reduction. Which means, so if you have a momentum map there, then this space is a symplectic manifold. The symplectic form is actually induced by the original space. That is the content of the Marsden-Weinstein symplectic reduction theorem. So in our setting, we know that the curvature map is momentum map, and we can prove that is a similar theorem to Marston's tidy doctrine theorem. So we can take the quotient, the Marston's time quotient on that infinitesimal space, and we can have finite dimensional simple manifold. So first, let me remark this gauge group is infinitesimal space, and this is just zero locus of that momentum map, which is curvature. So zero locus of curvature map is in fact a flat connection, which I defined before. But that space of flat connection is also infinitesimal space. So, but the quotient space turns out to be a finite dimensional space, and this is usually called the drum group point. Now, let me give the local structure of drum group point. The tangent space of this infinitesimal space is in fact given by this one. This is actually coming from the decomposition after trivialization. After trivialization, we see that this space, the curly A space, is a fine space modeled to this endomorphism based one-form space, and tangent space is in fact the same as this. Now, tangent space of this flat connection, which is the zero locus of a momentum map, is not hard to see that this given by this equation. But from this equation, we can say that this space is in fact the same as a closed cycle with respect to this operator d eta. And we know that the vector field is generated by the derivation of this re-algebra element. That means, that implies when you take a quotient space, the action of GL is translated into co-boundary operator. So exactly the d eta and x in here. And this is in fact the definition of Gram cohomology's local coefficient. So you can have this space, and this is Chaisky tangent space of this. Let me give some example about what I have done so far. So let's restrict ourselves to the simplest case. This is what is the simplest case, the Lyman-Lee case. The flat connection is given by, because of the formula of curvature formula, is nothing but the closed form. And it's not, you can see that this one, and the space of a flat connection is, let me denote that the space of flat connection is a space of a closed form space, and in our case, the gauge group is in fact C infinity map from M to C star. Now, using exponential sequence, the drum group point is in fact given by this way. What the reason is that this GL0. GL0 is the space of a map. Space of a map in this C star. Such that G is a null homotopy to constant. Homotopy to constant. That G will be known to G0 space. Now this space is the same as this one. And this space, the quotient space by the number of components which is not a holotropic constant is characterized by this H, homology group with G coefficient. This is the same thing as so we can say this, this G is made in here and this is the then let's take the pi 1 from here, pi 1 G it goes to pi 1 and 2 pi 1 sister. Now this is really see this isomorphic to G. Now, as pi 1 G is an element in harm, pi 1 and G, which is H 1. Of course, there is a corner here. So this is a subjective map. So there is a corner really characterized by a homotopic map, the homotopic constant map. Now let me state the theorem about the correspondence between the Hilbert point and the Langevin point. So this is proved by the Andre Weil. The idea is to make a construct monodromy operate monodromy from given connection. The monodromy matrix is indexed by this way. The gamma I is the basis of the first homology group. And if you have a monodromy row, then you can construct this associated flat vector model, which is invected given by pi 1 electron here. This m theta is universal covariance space of m, and the cn pi 1 electron cn by this representation rho. And this trivial space has a natural flat structure, which is nothing but its trivial derivative, and you can induce that its trivial derivative to the quotient space, and that gives the flat structure on that space. This is the idea of proof of this correspondence. Now, so let me define the hexagon for rank 1. The holomorphic structure is the complex vector bundle of a compact element of this differential operator. This is why this condition is there, so there are some differences between connection and holomorphic structure. But still, I'm assuming the vector boundary is a smooth complex vector boundary. Now, rank 1, this boundary is a pair of holomorphic structure, is T at 2 prime, and holomorphic 1 bomb is respected to this holomorphic structure. Now, exactly the same reason, like the Fischer trivialization, we can. So, here D0 is just the trivialization with respect to the the connection with respect to this trivialized flat connection, and just take 0 to 0 1 part of the thing. Now, let me note that. So from this one, it is not hard to see that the space of all holomorphic structure is a high space on the door. This is the complex spaced form of type G1, and the total group point is in fact defined isomorphic holomorphic structure across this space of all. Holomorphic on form. now running the correspondence between ground group point and third-order point. So in order to prove this one, the main idea of proof of this is construction of the value of the matrix, which means in order to prove the one direction, you need what is called the adaptive matrix, and in the other direction, you need the harmonic matrix. But I will define this one now. Now, adaptive matrix, H to a holomorphic structure is a Hermitian matrix with a unique unitary connection comparable with this D to prime is flat. This is the definition of this adaptive matrix. Now, from the Hatchi theory, I'm assuming M is a compact element. So this, we know that the Taylor matrix in fact gives this decomposition, orthogonal decomposition of this type A01 space. So from this one, if you have a type 01 form on M, then you can decompose naturally this psi 0 is in fact 01 form with respect to this D bar operator, and you can find the G. G is an element in the phase group. Now, we can see that given this holomorphic structure psi, you can find the psi 0. This is coming from actually Hatchi theory. And you can make this whatever is this operator. But it turns out that this operator is flat. This one is flat. So that's the main point of this construction. So given holomorphic structure, I actually associate some flat unitary connection, which is not necessarily the same as psi. So it's just psi 0, which is depends on this decomposition. So what is the whole new M? So in fact, this it's not easy to make the natural correspondence between this space and this space. So this is actually some kind of covering space of this whole M. So I don't want to explain what this space, but in fact, this one is a covering of this one. So in fact, using this one, you can in fact make this diagram really one-to-one correspondence. And from this one, so it's a given Higgs bundle, which is the holomorphic structure, and this holomorphic one form. Then you can make this flat connection by this way. So what is important is if we take this psi 0 as a dead decomposition, then this guy is in fact flat. So I defined one, I proved one direction. And let's go to the other direction. The Hermitian matrix on the line bundle is a harmonic. We say that if it's a log H is a harmonic function, let's see. So let's say given this flat connection eta, the real part of eta is in fact declosed form. So it is well known that declosed form is represented by D harmonic form. So the psi 1 is harmonic form. But you can actually prove that if Q1 is a harmonic form, then this log H is harmonic in this sense, harmonic function. So, in fact, this decomposition already gives in N quantities harmonic matrix. And so, if you find this eta, then this is in fact Q1. The feeling is disharmony form. But the Hachi spirit tells us that disharmony form is in fact the same as Diva harmony form. Diva harmony form is in fact Diva closed. So this one is in fact inside of this Holoma form. And this one is in fact Holoma destruction. So I in fact prove the correspondence between the flat connection and fixed bundles. So even though I actually just give a definition, I did not construct this method because if I use the Hachi theory, actually that information is encoded in all the Hachi theory. So you don't see in fact this machinery. You don't need this machinery, just you need in order to prove this theorem, you don't need this the new concept. But the reason I want to tell you this one today is I will generalize, in order to prove the general case, the Hachi theory is not enough because there is no Hachi theory for a higher rank case. So I will generalize this concept to higher rank case. And then, so tomorrow I will make the prove the correspondence between Volvo and Higgs bond in terms of this. That's it. And so now, so we know that this is just the H1MC by H1MG. So because it's a closed form, then if we take the unique harmonic representative of that thing, then it's, you can just by taking 1-0 form to the last phase. I need some kind of this kind of thing, making this space is around the bar closed. But if you just directly take this harmonic form here, then the 1-0 part would be enough to give the D-bar closed. Okay, now let me explain the hyperplane structure of three modular space, Volvo and drum and that's it. The hyperplane manifold is Riemannian manifold is three covariant constant, orthogonal automorphism of the tangent bundle, that's by this Cottonian relation. So the covariant constant means the this is parallel with respect to the Dirichlet connection of the Riemannian metric. And if you have these three complex structure, then you can define this way, three real valued symplectic form. And moreover, you can, if you make, if you write this way, then this omega I is complex based symplectic form, but it turns out that this is holomorphic with respect to this I structure. Now the Riemannian metric in our Volvo group void is a very given by this one. So eta 1 is just the flat connection. So I will define this way the Riemannian metric in there. And the I structure is defined by this one. But let me remark that this I structure is not canonical I structure on flat connection. But this I structure is in fact the canonical I structure on Higgs bundle space because it just is a multiplication by I. But this J structure, if we define this way, this is the canonical complex structure on space of flat connection, then this J structure can be translated in this way, in the X coordinate, okay, from the X coordinate, and the K structure, I think that the composition of this one. Now, let me give you a quick example of this equivalence. So, because the C star is Abelian group, so there is no action on this space of representation, and so this space is nothing but sister 2G space. And this space of flat connection, made up by this KG group, is nothing but this space. This is in fact, this is C2G. and this is G2G. And this space is isomorphic to sister 2G space. Hence, the Betti groupoid and the Drum groupoid is isomorphic as a compressory group. On the other hand, this fixed bundle space is the gauge connection is always is similar to the, in this because there is no gauge action on this space because it's a rank one case. And so we can easily see that this, this space is isomorphic as this one. But this is in fact a CG space. This is a CG. And this is a G2G, the same as. Then this is what is called Sakurai-Bora variety. And this is in fact Sakurai-Bora, same as Sakurai-Bora variety cross this H, the space of holomorphic form. But this, in fact, is a well known fact that the potential bundle of this is nothing but complex, compact complex towards the potential bundle of that is always trivial. So this is potential bundle of that one. Now this space is made the same as this one. So this is in fact the real isomorphic, but it is not a complex isomorphic. The main reason is this space. It's a same manifold. The same manifold does not have a compact, complex sub-manifold. But as we see, this fixed bundle has a compact, complex sub-manifold inside of this one as a zero locus, which is the Sakurai-Bora. So two spaces cannot be isomorphic to each other. Now, so let me define the real structure. First, let's define the involution on this the space of flat connection following way. And that, in terms of its coordinate, that your structure is in fact given by this way. And there are another, we can define the involution, and we can define this way. Now, let's consider the fixed point of involution. The fixed point of involution in here should be this one, should be real manifold. So involution, because this involution in fact fixed the zero section of this tangent bundle, this is Sakurai-Bora variety. And in fact in this way, you can say the space of flat connections. But this one is in fact inside, the thing inside is a real manifold. Which means it is a real manifold with respect to J. So this involution is in fact a real structure with respect to J. But this space is exactly sit inside as a complex manifold. So which means this is not real structure with respect to this R. So there is some difference. Now let's see another involution. So another involution in fact is the two torsion point of the Sakurai-Bora because the involution by definition minus psi is equal to psi, so it becomes two torsion point of this Sakurai-Bora variety. And this space also sit inside the real space, and this is in fact this R, this one is exactly the same as R cross which he defined this is R minus zero, so this is disconnected space. So Sakurai-Bora, the two-torsion point is in fact given by this one. So this is a disconnected space with a 2D, 2G copy of this one. But this is a holomorphic, this is a complex manifold inside of this one. So this one, again, this is a complex manifold and this is a real manifold. So there is some difference between I and J structure. And another fixed point is here. It is the composition of two. And the last thing is the alpha is splitting your form of this C star. And that is that this component is in fact the identity component of this space. And we will generalize this one, which is turned out to be Euclidean space of R plus 2G. That is the isomorphic R 2G space. We will generalize this to the higher rank case, which is, you will see that this is some kind of a particular space for the higher rank. Let me start here.